Welcome to my channel, Fat Danny Lounge. My name is Mildred Lee. My cell phone has a little bit of energy, so I have to charge my cell phone. My cell phone is around my neck. I have my neck brace on because I have to show you something. Oh, shit. So I get this bag again. This is my Flying Tiger tote bag, cotton tote bag, because I don't like to carry a lot of plastic around me anymore. As you know, you have seen, or maybe not. Oh shoot, my bag, my box. It's dented. Shoot. I love to have my box a little bit pristine. Sorry, my. Never mind, my box fell down. I'm surrounded by my stuff. I'm sorry. I have not, like I said, cleaned 100% or organized 100%, but I wanted to show you something. In my tote bag, there is something. Oh, everything falls out. I have to grab this little thing. I don't need the tote bag, but the little thing was in my tote bag. So I have to show you. And there's another thing. Sorry, I try not to feel my legs. I also have to grab this bag. I will talk to you about another time. But in this bag, there is a book that I bought. So I have to get the bag out of the equation. So as you know, there my neck brace is not 100% on my neck. As you know, my goal was to go to Amsterdam to the Art of the Brick. It's an exhibition. Now I forgot the name already. Never mind. I think it's in there. Yeah, Nathan Sawaya. So Nathan Sawaya, I don't know the total background because I did not search it up, but I believe he's a big Lego player. He makes a lot of images or how do you say it? Models and made of bricks from Lego. And while he was making some of these, he thought by himself maybe it's good to have an exhibition. So, and it's also another way to earn money, so I think that's a good idea. I have seen one in the past, and I know that this must be a second exhibition. I didn't go to the first one, that's why I wanted to go to the second one. And I try not to wrinkle it. Okay. So I saw it online on Instagram that you could order the tickets. So I ordered the ticket. I don't like to do business via Instagram because of that incident that I had, this necklace incident. But I thought to myself, if the Instagram is reputable, I mean the exhibition ticket sales is reputable, so it's legit, then I can order it. So I tried to look at the website. It was good enough. So I tried to do on Google to see on that website, because that's more legit, I think. And I ordered a ticket for the exhibition, and I didn't want to order at the time that I ordered it. When was this? Somewhere in July. Yeah, somewhere in July. Or somewhere. Wait. Somewhere in August? Never mind. It was not in July. Somewhere in August, I saw it. I didn't want to order it right away. The tickets, how do you say? Find a date more over the next 1 or 2 weeks. Luckily, I did that because in that particular week, my son had was told by his dentist that he had to take out his wisdom teeth. So I did it in my own experience when I did my let people remove my wisdom teeth. It was done by the hospital because at that time the dentist was not very confident to do it himself or let someone do it in their practice. So they always referred to the hospital because maybe they don't be liable. Maybe sued by people, so that's why they referred to the hospital. My son had his first removal, wisdom teeth removal was also good, but we didn't know this time it turned out so bad. So luckily I ordered these tickets 2 weeks later. My son had a horrible aftermath after the pulling the wisdom teeth, not by the hospital, by their own dentist practice. They had, I think, a surgeon or a dentist that is more pull strength. I don't know. They don't do it like pulling immediately. They do it, of course. They do a syringe in your teeth. How do you say the thing where your flesh is, or inside your mouth? I don't know. They sedate the space, so when they pull it, you don't feel the pain. But it was not that; it was something else. I will say in another vlog about that. But I had to take care of my son. That's why I didn't post any pictures, anything else anymore on YouTube and on Instagram. Because he, in his first wisdom teeth removal, I think 2 years ago, nothing was wrong after that. But this time it was a bit horrible. He had a lot of pain. He had antibiotics. He had painkillers. Still, it was hurtful. He couldn't grind his food with his molars. So everything hurt. He had to eat soft food. So I had nothing else anymore in my house to eat. So I had to make special diet foods like yogurt, soup, vegetables that I have to soften it to cook much longer. So there was a lot of things I had to take care of my son. And okay, previously I had to go to the pharmacy to get his medication also. So when I was looking after him, I myself got sick. I had a lot of stress. I don't know why I had a lot of stress. Well, I know why, but I won't tell you. So luckily, my body was a bit deteriorating and I didn't feel it well. I didn't understand why I was not feeling well. But suddenly I remembered, hey, this is not the first time. This is not my first rodeo, my body acting up like this. So I finally found out my body was actually crashing down. So I had to tend to my son and tend to myself. I didn't have to look after my youngest. He can look after himself. He's now 19. So I had to think quick because I thought to myself, I have to tell the art of break that I have to get my money back. I would not attend the exhibition. But I was afraid, like, hey, maybe they will not give my money back. So I have to be, that was A, to tell them I need my money back. Because I'm not going to attend. Or B, I have to be quickly. And I have to be well. My body needs to restore and be better. Otherwise, I need to be at this exhibition. Because I don't think they will give my money. But I have to attend it. So that's I did everything to in my power to get better. Luckily, I got better. And I went to the exhibition, The Art of Brick. But the day, the night before The Art of Brick, that week prior to this day, I was looking like, how much does it cost me to travel by train if I get better? How much does it cost me, the train fare? So I was looking it up and I was like, ooh, okay. Isn't there not a cheaper way to minimize the cost, the traveling cost? And luckily I remember there is some such a thing in the Netherlands that you go by train. Well, it used to be like this. You go by train and it's a day price or a day ticket for €17.50. But if it's off season, it will be €19.50. Luckily, it's summer. So I was hoping it will be €17.50. So that means that if I had to pay full price, I was like, I think €20 for traveling. But I think it was €20 or €30 go and back, traveling by train. So we call it retour. That means you go to that place and from that place back to your own hometown. But you could also travel one-way ticket. So you pay that price. And when you go, when you are there and you have to pay the other ticket, same ticket, one-way ticket, but then go back. So if you do it this way, you are more expensive than buy a retour ticket. Retour ticket is like this and this. It's all included. So I thought to myself, So I have three ways to pay for the traveling. And I thought to myself, I think the day ticket is much cheaper because it's €17.50 all included. It used to be like this. Train, bus and tram or metro, it was all included in that €17.50 or €19.50. But now they are smarter. They want the train fare just like that. Only the train fare. So luckily, I was thinking about, ooh, I need to get better. I need to get better. Once I get almost better, I pay for the train ticket, the €17.50, the day ticket. And I thought myself, how can I take the most out of the train ticket? So if I go early to Amsterdam, maybe I can attach a day to The Hague to go to P.W. Ackerman. That's a fountain pen store in The Hague. And I can go to Gouda to play today the Lego store. So I'm going to The Art of Brick, the fountain pen store, P.W. Ackerman, and go to the Lego store in Gouda. But once I was there in Amsterdam, I got lost. Even though I asked the woman at Allard Pearson Museum, she says there was a moat in between. So she said, if you walk around the moat and go to that alley, you will find the Kalver Passage, the one that you're looking for. But once I was go around the moat, I thought myself, all the time I did not open my cell phone because my previous cell phone, the iPhone 6, whatever you do, it depletes very quickly. It was not half day past, it already depleted. So I thought myself, okay, I have now an Oppo Reno 4. I am scared that my cell phone is depleting, even though I have my supercharger. I already charged it. And I thought to myself, I need to be careful with filming, photo making, and making vlogs. So I thought to myself, be gentle with the energy of your cell phone and supercharger. I wasn't even attaching the supercharger to my cell phone. I was only talking about my cell phone. So I thought to myself, okay, maybe it's time I open the Wi-Fi on my cell phone and see for myself the Google Maps, because don't listen to the woman, go by yourself. So I was looking in Google Maps and I was lost 5 to 8 times. That's how how stupid I was, in 2 hours. So I only wasted 2 hours. So I was so tired. Luckily, in between the 5 and 8 times of being lost, I thought myself, have a quick lunch at the supermarket. Let's get some croissant and something else, just to, because I didn't have breakfast. I'm diabetic and I should have had breakfast, but I was already late. I was doing things for my son, preparing a little bit of food and getting everything ready. I was already running late. I should have been at 9 o'clock at Central Station Rotterdam. I wasn't. I was finally in Amsterdam at 11. Like I said, I was already lost 2 hours. It's already 1 o'clock. And finally I found... I was telling myself, listen to the woman, go to that alley right across the Albert Pierson Museum, across the moat, there is an alley. Go there and there must be a golf passage. Okay, I was going there. I was like, shoot, it was right there. I was just being dumb and stubborn. So finally, I was there. Luckily, I had, like I said, in the first week of August, I purchased this online. This cost me €19.90, the ticket alone. Like I said, the day ticket for the train was €17.50. And I paid one-way ticket to go by metro, and it was like €1.19. So that's the only thing that I paid for going to the Art of Brick. So, like I said, it's Nathan Sawaya made all these Lego, how do you say it, sculptures. So, once I visited the exhibition, before I asked the young boy at the bottom of the escalator, I asked, can I take pictures? He said yes. Oh, I said, thank you. I went up, I took some pictures, a little bit of small videos, and this is the beginning. I cannot show you a photo because it's inside my cell phone, and I'm shooting this video with my cell phone. So I... once I've visited the exhibition, it was like a small mall, the smallest mall you've ever seen. But once you go to the escalator to the first floor, American called the floor ground the first floor, and you go the escalator, it's called the second floor. But we Dutch people, we called it the ground floor, begane grond. And once you go to the first floor, it's the first floor. So that's the difference between Europeans and Americans. Okay, I go there. There is like the first whole floor of the small mall is all divided in like a labyrinth. Pathways of the sculptures that is divided in colors, because Lego has colors. Then once you finished it, it ends up in kind of playground for kids to have. How many were there? I don't know how many there were. There were like it looks like billiard tables, but on the tables it was stacked with a lot of Lego pieces and bricks for children to play. So after they did visited the exhibition, afterwards they could relax and make buildings, mock buildings with the Lego. But there was also a wall there you could put your small flat mock means my own creation. You mock pieces attached to the wall, and sometimes they refresh it and take some parts out, and so other people, visitors, can attach their mock pieces onto the wall. Okay, then you go down the escalator. There is a small corner store where you can buy Lego stuff. I saw a lot of old Lego sets. There was one, it's called Lego Movie. I think you can put it in your desktop or laptop or whatever computer you have. It's a program so you can make movies or videos with your Lego pieces. There was no price. I didn't buy it. I didn't want to buy a lot of stuff because then you have to carry it all the way back. And I had three plans: to visit Amsterdam, then The Hague, and then Gouda. So I thought to myself, it would be bonkers to buy a lot of stuff, but you have to carry all these things with you. So I didn't want to buy a lot of stuff. The only thing that I bought in this little store of The Art of Brick, that was this t-shirt. I'm a big girl, so everything I buy is extra large. So I bought this uniform t-shirt. It has this printed logo on, The Art of Brick, Nathan Sawaya. What does it say here? Oh, the exhibition in Dutch, the tentoonstelling. There was not a t-shirt that was already unfolded. All were folded and stacked. So I'm not sure if in the back side is a pattern. No, it's not a pattern. So they did it cheaply. Well, the t-shirt was cheaply. It was only 10 euros. So I paid for the exhibition souvenirs. So this is the t-shirt that I bought, €9.99. And because I want something of the exhibition, I bought this little book. This little book is very thin, but not also too thin. There were three of them. There was in Dutch, in French, and in English. All the Dutch versions had a plastic cover. It was vacuumed, sealed. The French was stack was half-half, but all the English one had no vacuum plastic sealing cover. So I took the one that was not so damaged. So the top was a little bit damaged. I took the little bit center part. I wanted a little booklet that was 100% not touched with fingerprints and dentations or foldings. So that's why I bought this. It was for €14.95 or €14.99. Doesn't matter, it's 15 euros. So I bought this book. And there's all these sculptures that Nathan Sawaya made. I did take pictures, but I did not take all the pictures of all the sculptures. On, I think, two or three sculptures I did not take picture of because I didn't think it was that interesting. But I think you will find it in this book because everything that Nathan Sawaya made with the Lego, it must be in this book. Even I didn't take all the pictures. So this is Nathan Sawaya, and this is his profile or credential or biography. How you say it? This is where he works in his studio. There you go. There was a picture of it was so beautiful. It was a setting. Lego setting, and there was a man sitting on an actual chair, and the proportion was so accurate. It was so good. I took a picture of that. I don't have it here. I will show it in Instagram. There was also a cello. It was life size. It was so good and so beautiful. And my fascination for Apple. I don't know why. Maybe because it's a forbidden fruit. Eva was kicked out of the heaven, out of paradise because of the apple. So I think that's my fascination for apple. There was also a block. It was like a frame, more like a box. There was a tear in here and then a sculpture coming out. But it was an actual box because it was here was a side of Lego, then here, then there, and there. Because I stood next and I took a picture sideways. It was an actual box. But the thing is, I don't know why. I have some fascination for phallic and vulva. Every time I see food, I think it looks like a penis. Penis shape. Everything that I see, it looks like a vulva. This thing also, I don't know why. It looks like a vagina with a man sticking out. I know it was not his intention. I'm sorry. My mind is a bit sick and morbid. Okay, sorry. Next. I took the picture of this. This is so fun. Oh, there was also this. In Lego, there is called Lego Art. It's a set that you can buy. You can have in one in Sith, one in Andy Warhol. Was it Marilyn Monroe? There was one in Disney Mickey Mouse. There's one in Disney Mickey Mouse. Minnie Mouse. But I saw in this exhibition there were some of these Lego prints. And this one, he did not specify who this is. But these two pictures is actually Nathan Sawaya's wife. So you have one in sepia color and one in black and gold color. And it's hard to find gold brick pieces. But he did it. So these are all his sculptures that he made. This one I also like. You know, there's a thing called human body. And I don't know why. People in these current times like to see other people or themselves like perfect. They think perfect body is a goal we strive for. But what actually is, in reality, people don't look perfect. People don't look flat tummy, don't look big-breasted. There are all people in all kinds of shapes and size. And I like how Nathan Sawaya made this figure, this man and woman, not perfect. Actual realistic. And I like that. I like that a lot. So he did a lot of body morphing or body shapes. And there's also some of the Greek or Roman statues that he also did. I like that a lot. Oh, this one's also beauty. This one was, it was like this man was floating in the air. So beautiful. But of course, there are some lines hanging from the ceiling. So it makes him float in the air. But he was not actually floating. He had some suspension attached to the ceiling. There was a lot of... Oh yeah, this statue was actually in a glass casing. That was so crazy how he makes the body almost perfect. The proportion was so good. This one was also beautiful with the lightning. No, with the lighting. Oh, so beautiful. He did also some of the paintings that he... These are the classics. I saw this one. I saw also this one. I don't know if I saw this one. I don't remember if I did see this one. So it is so funny to see the actual, you see these paintings in books or in school books or in books or in museums itself or in media, but now you see them in Lego shape. It's so funny to see it, that it is possible. This one I did see. The other ones I did not see. This one I did see. These two I did see, but I don't remember seeing this one. I don't remember seeing this one. But I took pictures, so... Let's see. When is the exhibition ending? I believe it's 28. Wait. Is today the last day? Yes, today is the last day. This one is special to my heart. Because my favorite museum is here, right behind my house. No, not right behind, but almost right behind my house. It's called Museum Boijmans van Beuningen. And on the street, right before the museum, there's a bronze statue. And it's of this how do you say it? Lego thing. It is not made of Lego, it's made of bronze. It stood there years, years, years on the street. And because Boijmans van Beuningen is renovating and also building a new museum, it's called the Depot, they took the bronze statue out of the street and lent it to Russia. So Russia has kept it for, I don't know, for some time. And then afterwards, they have to ship it back to Rotterdam, the Netherlands. And once the renovation stopped or finished in the museum, and the depot also finally starts opening, I think the statue will come back. So it's one of my favorite statue of Museum Boijmans van Beuningen. This one I saw also. This reminds me of Doctor Who, of the Weeping Angels. I saw this one. I don't remember seeing this one. Oh, my favorite painting, The Kiss. He did it. How is it possible? Nathan Sawaya made a Lego statue of The Kiss. An actual 3D. An actual one. I saw this one too. It looks like glass stained window. That was so beautiful. There's also a little space. It's called Dinosaurium. But it's actually one Tyrannosaurus Rex skeleton made out of Lego. He only did one dinosaur. There was not a lot of. But this one was pretty big. I took also pictures. I had to take a picture of one, the head, the middle and the tail. I could take a picture of the whole skeleton, but I had to walk back to get it perfect in frame. But I told myself it's better to do it like in three separate ways. There you have it. That's the one. So yeah, it's my two things that I bought at the art of exhibition, the brick art, the art of the brick. That was my day, and because I lost a lot of time, I decided I was very tired already visiting this exhibition, so I decided not to go to The Hague, to the fountain pen store and ink store, P.W. Ackerman. But I was a little bit dumb. I was traveling to Gouda and I realized, shoot, there is a P.W. Ackerman in Amsterdam. So dumb. Okay. I'm going to end this little video because there is a lot I want to talk about Amsterdam visit. But I think it's better to cut it in pieces, bite-sized pieces, so it will not overwhelm you how my day was in Amsterdam. Thank you for watching and I hope you enjoyed my little vlog of the Art of the Brick exhibition of Nathan Sawaya. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.